This is Joni Rae.
KEVIN BLANCH. This is a group of activists as we all join together today in the anti-nuclear protests on the Songs Restart-Up. There's an incredible group of activists in this photograph. What a photograph. The lighting's so perfect. And what a beautiful mix of strong activists coming together all at once from all over the United States.
All with concerns of safety, because this doesn't just affect Southern California and 8 million people.
The lessons, this is a global issue.
Yeah, this is a global issue. This is like, you know, lessons that weren't learned from Fukushima. And people want to know why. What is the NRC hiding? What is going on with Southern California Edison? Why are they pushing to restart a failed nuclear reactor
that sits on three faults? You know, right here, and with more spent fuel laying in the site than any other reactor in the country, the most flawed design. It's had the spent fuel, more spent fuel rod problems than all other, the other 103 combined. I mean, it is an absolute disaster. Songs is a disaster as it sits, and it is a disaster. So it is the,
it's a disaster waiting to happen. Even though it's shut down, it's still dangerous with the spent fuel rods, 40 plus years stored in one site. And as KEVIN found out, they had a backdoor ruling.
Yeah, they had a backdoor ruling. I really didn't understand. I knew this, and they've been told that the spent fuel rods are stored on site, which is illegal, and it's been illegal for years. Well, they backdoored how they pulled this off. They turned all 104 nuclear sites into official nuclear waste dump sites now.
Storage.
Yeah, and they've never been set up for that. But that's how they backdoored it, because they were in violation of the law. So they backdoored that way into it. So here it's all sitting there. Never built to sit there. Just sitting there on trays, in cooling ponds, sitting there with never set up for it.
Right, it was never set up for it. And so as the years went by and went by, they kept hoping that somebody would figure out a safe way to store them or utilize those spent fuel rods. And that never happened. So that's a whole nother issue. But nonetheless, it's still a very serious issue. So I'm going to let KEVIN set this up because he knows this woman personally. This is Cathy Iwan.
Yeah, Cathy's and I's story goes all the way back. It's a really emotional story. It goes clear back to the day that Fukushima happened. Cathy and her young children and her husband were living in Japan. And they're very close to being wiped out by the tsunami. It was very traumatic on their family. And she was in my sight immediately the first few days. And you know, the only information she was getting was a lot from my videos. And we developed a relationship. And she's turned into one powerful, amazing activist, this woman.
So we're going to listen to her story.
Japan, after raising my daughters and living there for 25 years, I cannot stress enough that the three nuclear reactors in Fukushima continue to melt down, releasing tons of radioactive runoff water each and every day into our Pacific Ocean for the last almost 2 years. Contrary to popular belief, this disaster is nowhere to be completed or over. While the Japanese government and TEPCO, the people responsible for the meltdowns, feign decontamination, it is fact that these reactors are still too hot to cap, because in doing so, there would be explosions of unbelievable scale. They are so highly contaminated, in fact, that human workers cannot go in to begin repairs. Robots cannot even withstand the high temperatures. They just cease to operate. Commissioner William Magrud of the U.S. Nuclear Regulatory Commission, speaking about the Fukushima reactors recently, last year on October 12th in Washington, D.C., at a Senate Environment and Public Works Committee hearing in D.C., he said, and I quote, "It is difficult to underestimate the challenge of removing radioactive material from the area. there will need to be new technologies to accomplish the cleanup. And some of these technologies don't exist, he said. I live 380 miles away from the Fukushima reactors in southwest Japan in a place called Wakayama. I live with a Geiger counter measuring my food in the environment and also in the environment for a year before we made the decision to leave. I can attest to the fact that contamination in no way stays within the evacuation zone of 20 kilometers. Presently, 26 out of 47 prefectures in Japan are found to have trace measurements of radioactive cesium in their municipal water supplies. Now we're in San Onofre. Risky restart of the defective reactor number 2 at San Onofre is essentially rendering our children laboratory guinea pigs in Edison's nuclear experiment. It's our responsibility to protect our most valuable resource, our children. They are our future. My two daughters, who are half Japanese, I demand a transparent adjudicatory hearing with license amendment process, including hearings with sworn testimony from both sides, and cross-examination with experts outside of the NRC and outside of Southern Cal Edison. Edison refuses to submit their proprietary information that they've been sitting on October of last year. If they are confident of safe restart of the San Onofre reactor in April, what do they have to hide? We demand transparency and nothing less.
Yeah.
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 Yeah, very nicely spoken.
Beautifully.
What an incredible story that she actually survived Fukushima and now she's living here to share that. You know, this cannot happen in Southern California, too.
Yeah, how you love this photograph? Look, this is the parking lot at Songs, the employee parking lot. Look at the light poles. Oh, yeah, they're solar. Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
This was, we drove up to the facility so we could get some photographs. I didn't even notice. I just kept thinking that there's these big things that are in the way of my picture. And then Kevin pointed out, look at those big giant panels.
Yeah, solar. I knew there were solar panels right off the get. I'm like,
the hypocrisy of it all. The hypocrisy of it all.
It's like just spitting in our face and saying, look at us. We don't even believe in the freaking nightmare madness. But we're going to shove it down your throat anyway because we need to profit. State Street needs some more money.
Is that just amazing?
It's unbelievable.
Here you've got a nuclear reactor and solar panels in front of it.
In the employee parking lot. That's the employee parking lot right there.
Yeah.
Wow.
Unbelievable. Stay tuned for more. We've got a lot more. And thank you for watching.
Yeah.
And thanks again, Kevin.
Yeah, it's been an incredible day. A lot of powerful things happened today.
Yeah, indeed. As always, God bless.